I remember one story. Once upon a time, there lived a tiger in a forest and he became too old to hunt. One day, a gold bangle came across his side. He picked up. He planned a scheme to attract the traveler. One day, the traveler wanted to take the bangle, but he hesitated to go near the tiger. The clever tiger innocently said, "Listen, traveler, in my youth I was wicked, unquestionably. But now I have changed myself with the advice of a sannyasi." The traveler was greedy and jumped into the lake and got trapped in the marsh. Gradually, the tiger came towards the traveler and seized him. Then he realized, if only I had not let my greed overcome my reason, I could be alive. However, it was too late. The tiger killed the traveler and ate him up. So friends, what is the moral of the story? Greed never goes unpunished. So hello friends, Yasmin here from My Education, My Power, and today we'll learn how greed and foolishness can be turned into a curse from the story In the Kingdom of Fools from the book Moments, class 9. Let's know some interesting fact about the author. Poet, translator and philologist A.K. Ramanujan was born in Mysore, India. He earned degrees at the University of Mysore and Deccan College in Pune and a PhD from Indiana University. Ramanujan wrote in both English and Kannada, and his poetry is known for his thematic and formal engagement with modernist transnationalism. As a scholar, Ramanujan contributed to a range of disciplines including linguistic and cultural studies. Let's have a look on characters. There are mainly four characters in the story: the guru, the disciple, the king, and the minister. So friends, basically this story In the Kingdom of Fools is a folk tale that brings to light the dangers posed by foolish people. It also emphasizes the view that foolish people can be very difficult to manage. They can be dealt with only by the wise and calm people. The story is about a kingdom where the king and the ministers are nothing but fools. Let's get started. There was a kingdom where the king and his minister were fools, not very intelligent. And the king and his minister decided to do something very different to run the kingdom. They ordered the people that everyone in the kingdom would work at night and sleep during daytime. The people started doing farming, businesses and all kind of works at night only. As soon as the sun rose, everyone would go to sleep. The people were scared. If they did not obey the king's order, they would be sentenced with death penalty. One day, a saint arrived in the kingdom of fools along with his disciple. They were surprised to see that everyone was sleeping during daytime. In the evening, everyone woke up and started doing their work till the early morning. The guru and his disciple were very hungry. They went to buy groceries at night. They were surprised to see that whatever they bought from the shop costed only 1 rupee. Everything was at the same price, whatever they bought. The guru and his disciple were very happy as they could buy a lot of food just for a rupee. After some time, the guru realized that the kingdom was full of fools and decided not to stay any longer because it was unsafe for them. This disciple was a foodie and that is why he did not want to leave this place because the food was cheap. Guru failed to make him understand and finally the guru left the kingdom, leaving the disciple behind. But disciple wanted to live there to enjoy the food. Then disciple put on a lot of weight due to eating food all the time. One day, a thief entered a merchant's house by making a big hole in the wall. But as he was going out with the stolen things, the wall of the old house collapsed on his head and he died there only. The brother of the thief came running to the king and complained the king to punish the merchant for not building a good and strong wall and get compensation for his family. The king heard the case and found the merchant guilty of the thief's spot debt. The merchant pleaded in front of the king, requested that it was not his fault. The wall was weak because the person who made the wall did not construct it properly. Hence, he should be punished. So the king ordered to call the bricklayer who built the wall. The king said that the man had built a weak wall which fell on the poor thief's head and killed him, so he would be punished for this with death. The bricklayer pleaded the king that he was innocent and put the blame on dancing girl who distracted his attention by going up and down that street all day with her ankles jingling. The dancing girl, now became an old woman, was brought to the court. The king told her that as she was roaming around with her ankles jingling, it distracted the bricklayer. Due to this, he built a bad wall which fell on the thief and he died, and she would be punished with death. And then the dancing girl put the blame on the goldsmith. She told the king that she had given some gold to the goldsmith to make some jewelry for her, but he delayed the work and made her walk up and down to his house several times. That is why the bricklayer got distracted. Now the king says, yes, that the poor dancing girl was totally right. Then he ordered to bring the goldsmith in front of him. The goldsmith was produced before the king. After hearing the accusation against him, the goldsmith said that he had to attend to a rich merchant's order first, as there was a wedding ceremony in his family. It was therefore he made the dancing girl come to his door many times. The king asked the name of the merchant. Then the goldsmith said that the merchant was the same merchant whose house wall has fallen down. Justice has come full circle, means that the story ended at the same person from whom it had started. Once again the merchant was called. He was crying and he knew that the king was foolish and he would give him death sentence. He said that it was not he who had ordered the jewelry, but it was his father. But the father was no more in this world. The king thought that as the merchant's father was not alive and someone had to be punished for the crime, so he said that the merchant's son, who had inherited everything from his father, would have to die as punishment. After this, a new stake was ordered to be ready for the execution. But the merchant was too thin to fit the stake, so a fat man was searched for. The servant's eyes fell on the disciple who was fat enough to be executed with the stake. They found the guru's disciple who had become very fat because of overeating. Then the disciple requested and pleaded the king that he was innocent, but all went in vain. While he was waiting for death, he remembered his guru who saw everything in his vision. He was blessed with magic powers. He arrived at once to save his disciple. He whispered something in his disciple's ears. Then he requested the king to put him to the stake first, as he was the guru of the disciple, so he should be put to the stake first. When the disciple heard this, he said no, that he was brought here first, so he should be put to death first. The king was very surprised to see the fight between the guru and his disciple over the issue of who should be executed first. The king felt that there must be some reason behind it. When the king asked them the reason, the guru asked the king to promise him that he would execute him first. The king promised. Guru said that the one who would die first on this stake would be reborn as the king of the kingdom, and the one who died next would be the minister of that country. The king was puzzled. He did not want to lose the kingdom to someone else in the next life. So he discussed the matter with his minister, and finally they arrived at the conclusion that they should go on the stake to be reborn as king and minister. The king told his executioner that he would send the criminals at night. Firstly, they should execute the person who came first and then execute the second person. They should be careful and not make any mistake. So the king and the minister went secretly to the prison and freed the guru and his disciple. They wore the clothes of the guru and his disciple so that they resembled them. As it was told to the servants, they came and took them along and put them into the stake for execution. When the dead bodies of the king and his minister were taken away to be thrown, the people trembled to see the dead bodies of the king and his minister. Everyone was at shock. Everyone in the kingdom was mourning the death of the king and his minister. As the Guru and his disciple were planning to leave the kingdom, the people stopped them. The people of the kingdom thought that they needed a king and a minister. So they requested the Guru and his disciple to be the new king and minister of the kingdom, and then after they began to lead a normal life. So friends, basically we have got two messages from the folktale story. The first message is that one should stay away from the foolish people to get rid of the troubles. The second message is that in order to tackle foolish people, one should employ wisdom and not logic. So friends, hope you all like the story. See you again in the next video with another interesting story. Till then, take a very good care of yourself. Bye for now.